In this video, we're going to cover the Excel Chapter 10 workbook. And as you can see in this workbook, there's several different sheets. And these sheets pretty much coincide with the Chapter 10 presentation. So you have the Homestyle Furniture Sheet, Training Center, your Water Bank, Computer Software Package, Production Methods, Tax Preparation 1 and 2. And then we also have the Chapter 10 Question 35 Assistance Sheet. So plenty of sheets that you can refer to while reviewing the Chapter 10 presentation. What I really want to do is take a few minutes and show you the Kahoot examples and specifically how the sheets work with numbers given. Okay, so we're going to enter in the green cells to get this output, our standard error level, significant C value, our point estimate, our lower and upper limits, okay? To show you how Excel calculates these values, okay? So we have, okay, first story problem talks about salary information of two independent random samples of male and female employees from large companies. Okay, so let's look at this. Sample size, male and female, 64 and 36. So I'll type in 64 here and 36 here, right? Sample mean in thousands, so we have 44 and 41 for female. And then finally, we have the population standard deviation. Now, the problem is this, the variance, 128 and 72, 120 for male, 72 for female, but we need the standard deviation. So here's our hint. The population standard deviation is the square root of this population variance. So I'm gonna type in the Excel formula equals SQRT, 128 for male, and then female, SQRT, and the number 72 for female. Those numbers from here, 11.3 and 8.5, okay? So it gives us a population standard deviation. So I gotta kind of take a moment and convert them all, okay? Confidence coefficient, or coach 0.95. Again, it gives us a total standard error, level significance, Z value, margin error, our point estimate, our lower and upper limit. So it gives us all the calculations by entering in numbers in green. Let's look at the second example here. It talks about a cellular phone company. Again, they do an independent random sample of customers, okay? They got all the information here for female and male customers, an independent random sample, okay? Again, sample size, male 130, female 125. Sample mean given to us, 35 and 29. Now, look at this, population standard deviation, they give it to us here. So no conversions needed, 7 and then 5 for female. Again, I like to use, we'll use the 0.95 for a confidence coefficient. And all the numbers are calculated to a standard error, level of significance, Z value, margin of error, point estimate, and lower limit and upper limit, okay? So the next one talks about a production output, okay? It's for a random sample of days between two plants. What do they give us here? They give us the sample size, yep, 45 for plant one, 55 for plant two. Sample mean, 1,250 for plant one, 1,325 for plant two, okay. Finally, sample standard deviation. They don't provide it to us. They provide us the sample variance. So again, the sample standard deviation is the square root of the sample variance. So we're gonna take again, Excel from SQRT, we're gonna do 625 for plant one, we'll use that. Right to us, it's given to us. And plant two is SQRT of what? 676 for plant two, and we get 26. We use a magic number 0.95 here, and again, it gives us all the numbers here, okay? Standard error, level significance, C value, margin error, and our lower and upper limits, okay? So again, just simple, again, following along the same pattern. Again, the only trick here is you gotta convert over to standard deviation, the sample variance to a standard deviation, okay? Let's look at this one here. It says the following information was obtained for matched examples. Okay, so we're going to use our data analysis feature here in Excel. So I'm going to click on data analysis, and the feature we're going to use it's called the t-test paired two sample means. Okay, so we're going to take, okay, there's an example in the Chapter 10 presentation, but I just thought I'd show you how it's done here. So I click start over here. I'm going to give data analysis. I click data analysis in the pop-up window here. I'm going to select t-test paired to sample for means. Click OK. Where's our variable range for one? Let's see here. It's right here. Type one is here. What about type two? This column here. Hypothesize mean different. We'll just go over to zero for now. We do have labels. That's in our first row, if you would. Okay. And in our alpha, we'll go 0.05 in the output range again. I can do it in a new workbook. I have the output range appear in a new sheet here. And I'll just put the output right here in cell, select the cell F80. Okay. So now it gives us all our numbers here. Okay. Mean, variance, observations. What we're looking for is our T stat. That's a pretty important number, our T stat. Okay. So again, with a couple clicks of the button, I get my data analysis on these numbers here. Okay. So finally, okay, so we have one more here. We'll do here. It talks about a statistics teacher wants to see if there's any different than abilities of students enrolled in statistics classes today. Those are enrolled 5 years ago. Final examination scores from random sample students enrolled today and from 5 years ago were selected. Okay, so we got here today and 5 years ago. So we got X bar. We got, okay, well, let's look at sample. We got N. That's our sample size. We got 45. And 36. Sample mean, 82 and 88. Okay. 82 and 88. And finally, our sample standard deviation. Well, it gives us here our variant. We know, doesn't give us a sample standard deviation, okay? Because this here, so we're going to do equals SQRT. 2.5, and then we're going to do the same thing here with the 54. SQRT is a function, 54, and again, our confidence with just 0.95, and it gives us all the numbers we need here. Our standard error, our level of significance, our C value, our margin of error, and again, the point estimate difference in our lower and upper limit. Okay, so again, the point of it is I'm showing you is that if you enter into different numbers here, okay, the different numbers here, you get your, you can use here, you can get your, you get the values if you would, okay, that means you get your, you get the output, the yellow values if you would, okay, and that concludes this video.